My question to the Honorable Minister when she stands up to reply is that the RBI FSR report of December 2019, it says that the state-run banks account for 89.8% of frauds by value, private banks at 9.2% and foreign banks at 0.4%. This says a lot about the internal controls in the state-run banks. Now, what is the government doing? Because their hollow claim has been badly exposed by the RBI's report itself. My second question, madam, to the Honourable Minister is, when she stands up to reply, the PNB bank was hit with 20,000 crore, and we know Mr. Nirav Modi fled with more, and no heads have rolled so far. Why is that case? Third question is, the Modi government's real concern about PMC bank, which the Honourable Minister spoke about, when it came to Yes Bank, the SBI immediately infused funds into Yes Bank. Why this stepmotherly treatment for PMC? 60 people have committed suicide. What is the interest that government had with Yes Bank, and that same love is not shown towards PMC Bank? And what kind of administrator is working in PMC Bank from last 1 year? That person, that honorable person, has not been able to sell the yacht which is stuck in Sri Lanka. Two aircrafts are stuck in Mumbai airport. This is the love of this government for PMC depositors who are suffering day in, day out. Sir, my third question is about this. In this bill, it talks about issue of equity, preference or special shares by way of public's issue and private placement. Are you trying to say that now SEBI will interfere in it? Because this issue of equity and public issue, are you bringing in SEBI? Please, please enlighten all of us. My fourth question to the Honourable Minister is that RBI is being given power, is the government claim. If that is the case, why did Yes Bank, PNB, ILNFS and in March 2020, Franklin Templeton happened? What was RBI doing? What was this government doing? How did they allow all these four important things which happened? It was right under the rule of Mr. Modi. My fifth question is, since demonetization, the financial industry is slowly and steadily collapsing and showing how regulation by RBI, SEBI, NABARD is completely absent. So the way banks are now suffering, I feel one of the reasons is because of this unplanned Tughlaq-like decision of demonetization. Madam, sir, my sixth question is, this frauds reported by banks, which I said in the first point, about 1 lakh and above fraud has increased by 28%. Who's responsible for this? And may I request the government that Bank of Maharashtra, my colleague Mr. Imtiaz Jalil, MP for Aurangabad, is right when he said, told me that Bank of Maharashtra should not be privatized because it is running in profit. The government should not do it. And the last point which I want to know from the Honorable Minister when she stands up to reply is that this Modi government has this habit of encroaching upon, you know, basically weakening the federalism, encroaching upon the state list. You know for a fact what is the state subject, what is the central list. Why is it that you bring such a legislation wherein, what are your designs? Why do you want to weaken the federalism of this country, which is the basic structure of the constitution? By bringing in such a legislation, sir, we know for a fact what is in under the schedule 7, entry 32, entry 43. The honorable members have spoken on it. I don't want to highlight on it. And my last point, sir, is that this about this proportional voting rights. Now, if they buy equity shares in cooperative society, it's a known fact. One member, one vote. Are you going to overrule that? And also, isn't it a fact that the 2006 Vishwanathan committee recommended that cooperative banks should be allowed to raise capital through non-voting shares? So these are the important points. I hope the Honourable Minister, when she stands up to reply, she will definitely reply. And for God's sake, I don't want this Honourable Minister to say that all these urban cooperative banks and Nirav Modi, Mehul Choksi, PNB, Franklin Templeton, all were act of God. No, these are not act of God. They happened because Mr. Modi is ruling the country and because of the misgovernance and the act of themselves. Thank you, sir.